Actually, I must say, we are celebrating the launch of the Measuring the Information Society report. We are celebrating because we have very good news. The first good news is that the report reveals that the least developed countries has made very good progress in terms of ICT connectivity and also in terms of the use of ICT. The report also reveals that we have today 3.2 billion people that are online. And we have 7.1 billion people who have access to mobile subscription, of course. Then the report also reveals to us that the connectivity and the use of ICT is increasing very quickly, which is very important. And for me, as a director of Telecommunication Development Bureau, this is a very good sign that we can use the ICT for development, and see for that ICT for development. However, the report also is telling us that we still have 4 billion people who are not yet online. The report also telling us that we still have 350 million people who still don't have access to the mobile signal. So the report is telling us, finally, that we still have a lot to do to make sure that the poorest region and the most remote region and the most vulnerable regions of the world get access to ICT and use them to get out from extreme poverty and to get out from their vulnerability. The IDA for me is a very powerful tool for benchmarking. I think that the first thing about the IDA is for each country to measure its own development of ICT through a tool that is internationally recognized. So to track progress and also to compare itself to other countries that have got the same or similar economic and geographic condition, and to see and how you can share experiences and be inspired by others who have increased their IDI, and see how you can use their experience to increase your own. I think that this is how I will define the IDI. First, it's a tracking your own progress through the prism of an internationally recognized tool. That is the IDI. This year, ICT Development Index shows that the Republic of Korea is ranking the top, followed by Denmark and Iceland. But more importantly, it also shows what we call the most dynamic countries. These are countries that have made very good progress over the past 5 years. I can cite some of them. You have Costa Rica, Bahrain, Lebanon, Ghana, Thailand, Belarus, United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia, Suriname, Kyrgyzstan, and Oman. As you know, She just adopted sustainable development goals, recognized the crucial role of information and communication technologies. But more importantly, behind all those figures, statistics, and indexes, it is about human life. There are real human stories behind those figures and statistics. And it is about how we are using ICTs to alleviate poverty, to change the life of ordinary people. How are we putting in the hands of ordinary people a very powerful tool to make their own development, that of their community and that of their nation? So this is why it's so important for me.